For us to multiply, we have positive 8.3 times negative 0.4. Let's first determine the sign of the product. Well, because we have a positive times a negative, we know the product will be negative. Let's go ahead and record the negative sign in our product here. And now we'll focus on determining the product of positive 8.3 and positive 0.4. Let's first write the product vertically. Again, 8.3 times 0.4. Again, we're leaving the sign off negative 0.4 here because we already determined the product will be negative. The next step is to determine the number of decimal places in each decimal. 8.3 has one decimal place, and so does 0.4. Let's go ahead and record this information. Again, 8.3 has one decimal place, and 0.4 also has one decimal place. To determine the number of decimal places in the product, we sum or add these decimal places. Because 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, we now know the product must contain two decimal places. Next, we'll multiply as if we had whole numbers rather than decimals, so we'll find the product of 83 and 4. So 4 times 3 is equal to 12, perform an exchange with the 1. 4 times 8 is equal to 32, plus 1 is 33. So 83 times 4 is equal to 332. For 332, the decimal point is to the right of the 2. But now, because we know our product must contain two decimal places, we now move the decimal point to the left two places, so 1, 2, which gives us 3.32. So we now know that 8.3 times 0.4 equals 3.32, but because we have positive 8.3 times negative 0.4, our product is really negative 3.32. I hope you found this helpful.